It is impossible to change our feelings without changing our thoughts first. This is the premise of this video, and let me give you an example to better understand this concept. Imagine you're trying to teach a kid maths, right? You're trying to teach him that 2 plus 2 equals 4. We all know this, we don't even have to think twice. But when you're teaching a student, they may not understand this conceptually. And you try explaining it to them in multiple ways, right? You write it down, showing the number line, that if you have 2 and you add 2, you get 4. And you try and explain it, but they just don't understand. And when they don't understand, you get really angry and frustrated. You're like, oh my gosh, kid, like, why are you so not smart? Why are you so stupid? A lot of people would even insult them, even though they're just a kid. Because they're not understanding what you're trying to say, you insult them. You say, oh kid, you're so stupid. Why don't you know what this is? It's so easy. And in all reality, do you really think this is the right thing to do? Do you really think that insulting the kid will make them understand? That insulting the kid will make a world a better place? No, this is not true. Negativity brings on more negativity. This is just the nature of our world. It's like if you're insulting them in the first place, it may not even be that they're not understanding. It could be that the way you're explaining it to them may not be the best. It may be not clear. But anyhow, to avoid doing this, to avoid insulting other people, we must first change our thoughts, because our thoughts create our feelings. And so in the moment, we'll go back to this example. In the moment when you're teaching the kid maths, 2 plus 2 is equals 4, and they don't understand, before you react, close your eyes, or just zone out for a second and think in your mind consciously. Say, I am calm. The situation is all right. This kid will eventually understand, and I can explain this concept with more clarity. Even just hearing that, even me, when I just said it, I just had a feeling of calmness, a feeling of peace. I didn't have any urge to say anything bad or insulting to anyone. This is the fundamental truth of our world and our brains, is that our thoughts create our feelings. And if you have negative thoughts such as, oh, this kid is stupid, or oh, he's not smart enough, it will then create the feeling of anger and pain. However, to add to my final advice, if you can change your thoughts and think, oh, everything is okay, I am calm, I am peaceful, it will all work out in the end. You have then removed any thoughts that create negative feelings such as anger and pain, because thoughts create our feelings. That's the truth. So just remember, guys, in your self-improvement journey and in anything you do in your life, your thoughts create your feelings. So in order to start feeling happier, to start feeling more at peace, to start feeling more grateful, you must cultivate the right thoughts to acquire those feelings. Thank you.